One of the controls that is very popular on mobile devices in mobile apps is the bottom sheet. And in this video, we're going to see an amazing bottom sheet that you can use in your .NET MAUI application. So the bottom sheet is that little, well, it's not really a dialogue, but it comes up from like the bottom of your screen. And usually you can drag it like to be full screen, or at least it takes up like half of your screen, and you can drag it around a little bit and you can slide it to dismiss it. That's all kind of fun stuff that you can do. Strangely enough, there is not a lot of options for this pre-built, at least for .NET MAUI. But now there is this amazing plugin that does that. To be fair, there are a couple of blog posts that also describe how to implement a bottom sheet, and I will post those down below. But this is a plugin. It's currently in alpha stage, but you can just plug that into your application and you can start using that bottom sheet. Without any further ado, let's just go check it out. First, let's quickly give credits where credits are due. This is the GitHub repository. Everything is open source, as with a lot of stuff these days. And this is really amazing because you can also learn from how the code works in here. And it's called the 49 MAUI bottom sheet. I think D49 refers to the company name of the author of this library, who is Paul Verace. I hope I pronounced it correctly. Paul, thank you so much for doing this. I see sponsorship is not enabled, at least not for this repository. So see if you can sponsor Paul in any way for his work. Or at the very least, here, click the star button and star this repository to show you support for Paul's amazing work. Now here is everything you need to get started. The sample app, I'll show you that in a minute as well. And for the rest, of course, the source code for this wonderful plugin. And you can see here already a little spoiler alert for this Android and iOS screenshots right here. So I think that's the only platforms that are supported right now. But that kind of like makes sense as well, right? I think this is a control that is one of those that are very specific to like mobile devices. So Android and iOS, and you can see it looks pretty similar, and it looks as you would expect from a bottom sheet, right? So that's pretty cool. Now here's the setup. I'm not going to go into this in much detail because I'm just going to show you the setup, how to initialize it, how to use it in XAML. And then there is some description of like the APIs that are here and some things that are good to know. I think there are some differences here between like iOS doesn't support something just because it's not there on the platform. And there is a couple of things that are good to know. So definitely go check that out. Now, with that in mind, let's go to Visual Studio. I'm running here on Windows, as you might have already seen, and I hooked it up to a Mac on my network, and I can then show the iOS simulator. I'm going to show you Android in a little bit as well, and we'll get to that why I chose this setup for today. This is just a file new .NET MAUI application, so nothing fancy. You can see it here, the .NET bot. I can do the click me, and you can see it all works, right? And now I'm going to add that bottom sheet. So let me stop running the application for a little bit and go to my solution explorer. I'm going to right click on the project and do manage NuGet packages as we usually do. And I'm going to search for D49. Although the name is a little bit odd, it makes it very easy to find. And you can see it has a couple of other plugins as well, right? So definitely go check that out. If there's something you want to know more about the other ones, please let me know down in the comments. But we're interested in this, the 49 MAUI bottom sheet. It's a pre-release. It's actually labeled alpha. So it's a very early version. So please keep that in mind if you're going to use this. Also, you know, report any issues on the repository that we've just seen that you might encounter. I'm going to click install. It's going to install it on our project. Of course, we're going to view the license. We know that it's probably MIT, right? And the terms of usage. So we're going to accept that. And boom, it's installed. Okay. Now, let's go over here. The first thing you want to do is go to your Solution Explorer and go to your MAUI program. And this is something that's very typical now in .NET MAUI plugins. We need to do a little initialization line in the app builder. So let's just do dot use bottom sheet. And it doesn't add the using automatically. So I'm going to hover over here until the light bulb comes. And I'm going to do using the 49 MAUI bottom sheet. And it's going to add that here at the top. And now we're ready to use this bottom sheet. So let's do that. We're going to close this MAUI program. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to add a new page. Again, I'm going to go to my Solution Explorer, the project, right click it, do add new item. And I'm going to choose a .NET MAUI content page. Now, ignore that I have all duplicates in here. There's no difference. I don't know why that is. Probably my developer weird kind of setup. I did something at some point. I'm going to call this my bottom sheet, right? So my bottom sheet. I'm going to make an XAML. You can do the same thing in code if that's what you want, but I'm going to do it in XAML. So I have this page. And what you want to do, this needs to inherit from a special type of page so that it can be used with the bottom sheet plugin. So what you want to do is first add that XML namespace. That's something that we do a lot as well, right? Whenever we're using XAML at least. And Paul has this fancy URL set up as well. So I'm going to call this D49. He also uses that in a sample so you can see what's going on. And is, and I'm going to search for D49 again in the IntelliSense. You can find schemas.d49.com.net2023Maui. So he has the same kind of fancy URLs that .NET Maui has itself. That will, you know, if you want to know more about how this works, let me know down in the comments. I'm not going to go into that right now. So we have this one, and this makes it possible to use this instead of like the full namespace that you otherwise would have to use. So D49, and I'm going to do bottom sheet. And now we have this bottom sheet page. The title is not something that we can use, which is in the default template, so I'm going to remove that. And now, something that would typically happen if you're going to change this page type here is it's going to complain in the code behind that we're inheriting from two different things, right? So if we go to the Solution Explorer, to the mybottomsheet.xaml.cs, it here inherits from a content page, and we can't do that. Now, here's a little pro tip for you right here. You can just remove this one. You don't have to do it in two places. I don't know why that's in the templates. We should get rid of that. You can just do it like this, and you will never have that build error again. All right, my bottom sheet. So we got that all. Now, two things that I learned while looking into this is that you probably want to add a padding. It's actually one thing. I don't know why I said I learned two things. A padding of 16 and 32. That means it's going to be 16 left and right and 32 from the top and the bottom. That's because else your content will be all the way on the top on your sheet. It doesn't really look that pretty. And also if you do it full screen, it swipes off the whole screen. So that's something that you don't want to do. So we got that. And I want to set a little background. So, you know, if you're a better designer than me, and you probably are, it's not that hard. You can create a beautiful design here, right? But I'm just going to do this very simple design with a little label here, and I'm going to say, I don't know, what should it say here? Did you like and subscribe yet? Thank you. Maybe that's something that you want to do just off the top of my head. So like and subscribe. Thank you. All right. So we've got that. Let's make the font size a little bit bigger. Maybe font size is, I don't know, let's make it 32. Is that big enough? I don't know how that's going to be, but we'll see. So now I've got that in place, but now I want to show it, right? So let's go over to our main page, and I'm just going to reuse that counter button that we saw. I'm going to remove all the things here. We don't need that. And what I'm going to do is do var page is new my bottom sheet. And I'm going to create it like this. And then I can say page.show. And you have to specify the window. And the window is a property on each page, basically. So you can just say window. And this is actually like this dot window, right? So this is the window property associated to this main page. So you can just access that very easily. If you want to find your window reference, .NET Maui's multi-window now, please do and just put it in here and it will work. You can do some other things, which you can also do from XAML, but you can also do it like in here if you want to, you know, do something in code, maybe add some logic to it. You can do page.show handle. So show that little like gray thing on the top. Actually, let's set it to true so I can show you. You can do page.dismiss as well. So you can dismiss it programmatically. Or you have this event where it's dismissed and you can act on, you know, it being dismissed. You can set modal. I know the isModal, there is a note in the repository for that. So go check it out. I think it's not supported on iOS. So if it's modal, yes or no. And the other big one is cancelable. I don't know how to say that. Is, oh, that's not is. Oh, it's cancelable just. Not really consistent naming here. And that means if you can cancel it, yes or no, by swiping down. So basically this enables or disables the swiping down of the sheet. But I'm just going to keep it at the show handle right here. I'm going to do page.show and it's going to actually show. So let's run this on the iOS simulator and see what is going to happen. We should see the default .NET MAUI file new template, waving .NET bot and everything. And on this button, you can now have this bottom sheet that is going to show from the bottom. And that's what we're going to see. Okay, the application is built. It's being deployed to the simulator. So we should see it pop up on the right here. Here's our beautiful splash screen. And I should get myself out of the way here. So let me just do that for a little bit. And then here we have our application. So nothing changes just yet, but when I do the click me here, you can see this bottom sheet. Oh, look at that, the beautiful font. You can see that little handle. So that's the little bit darker gray thing, the little handle that you can, you know, it's a really visual indicator. So you can just take it there and do it a little bit up and down. If I slide it down, it's going to be dismissed. That is cancelable. If I set that to false, that cannot happen. But this is how it works. Now, one other cool thing that I kind of like skipped over. So if I'm going to stop this a little bit again, is the, I have to look up what the actual term was. Detents, I think, detents. And detents is the term for like the anchors where your bottom sheet can kind of stop. So let's do that in XAML actually, just to show you that this is possible in XAML as well. And let's do the 49 bottom sheet dot detents. I can specify them here. I can also specify them in code. And here, if you look at the IntelliSense, I have these detents, and you can set the anchor detent, the content detent, the full screen, the height, the ratio. So you have a couple of different options how to specify these things. Go check out the documentation. I'm going to do the full screen one, and you can have, this is like a collection. So I think I can do more right here. I can specify more, and you will have different anchor points where you can bring your bottom sheet up to. If you just do one, the full screen one, you can see that it will go to full screen and to like the regular anchor that we just saw basically, or just all the way dismiss it. So if I run this again, we should now be able to see that I can take that bottom sheet, I can show it all the way to full screen, and I can also do it back to like the original position or dismiss it altogether. All right, the application is coming up again. You can now see that whenever I click the button, we're going to see it in the default position, but I can now also pull it up to be all the way full screen. And you can see this is built into iOS. So the background kind of like, you know, goes to the back, more to the background even. It looks like really page sheets, and I can do it back to like this position. I can scroll it all the way back up here, and I can dismiss it all the way down. So that is a very cool option if you ask me. Now, the reason why I did all of this on iOS and not Android is because if I run this same thing on Android, so if I just switch over here to the Android emulator and the Pixel one, because that's the power of .NET MAUI, I can just switch over and I will have the same application, but now running on Android. You will see that there is something weird going on with the styling, and I am definitely doing something wrong, because this app that you just saw before mine came up is the sample app from the repository. There it looks beautiful, but if you look at my simple app right here, you can see that there's no background on Android. The handle is not showing. I can do it all the way up here, so the full screen kind of seems to work, and you can do it back, and I can dismiss it, but whenever I do, you will see this weird gap here at the top. So something is going wrong here, and probably I'm doing something wrong, because you can see in the other sample app that I will switch to in a minute that it can all work. Or there might be some bugs here, but you can definitely make it work, because if we go to the sample app, which is this one that's in the repository, you can see all these options, right? And here it works beautifully. So if I scroll up, we have this non-modal sheet. So that's kind of like my scenario right here. And I can actually, you know, slide it down and it will close again. If I do the modal sheet, you can see the screen even dims, so that, you know, you can't get really out of here by sliding. Well, it does slide, so I'm not really sure what the modal does here. But you can also click the dismiss, right? So that's the programmatically dismiss. The no sliding away is the is cancelable. So now I can't really slide it. Does it work if I tap outside of it? No. So that seems like the more modal option then to me. You really have to click this dismiss thing right here with the handle, and you can see that the handle also shows on Android. So I'm just definitely doing something wrong, right? So go check out this more complete sample for the Android one. Also, the background color just works here, and listen to that dismissed event. So I have all the stuff right here. This is really cool. You should definitely go check this out. I think this plugin definitely counts for Gerald's amazing plugin alerts. So there's that. And I really love this. Keep in mind, it's still alpha. It's still work in progress. Please make sure to report anything that you find. I'm not really sure what I did wrong on Android. It seems to work fine on iOS. So that's the little differences in platform development. Welcome to cross-platform development. But this is wonderful work already. Other than that, it works pretty stable. So really cool. Please check out my other videos on .NET MAUI plugins. On this playlist, there is a lot more cool stuff in .NET MAUI, or check all the .NET MAUI videos. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you on the other side.